In this section of the video, I'll be turning the crankshaft eccentric. Now, the purpose of the eccentric is to move the valve rod, not the connecting rod, but the valve rod up and down. And it does that in an opposite motion of the crankshaft. In other words, when the crankshaft goes up, the eccentric will pull the valve rod down. So they work exactly opposite of one another. Now there's a little bit of lead to it. It's not exactly opposite. There's a little lead that, so the air goes in the valving chamber slightly before the piston goes to, or right at the time the piston gets to top dead center. You'll see how that works a little bit later. But this is the eccentric right here, a basic drawing of what I'm going to be turning. I'll be using just regular mild steel. It's half inch, and I'll go through some of the turning processes here in just a minute. But this is the side view of it, and it's got a little boss or a little protrusion that comes off to one side, and this will have the quarter inch diameter hole for the crankshaft. I'll also have to put a set screw in it to tighten it to the crankshaft, and I'll also have to rotate on the crankshaft because this does the valve timing also. This is a side view of it. I'll have to cut a groove in it. The groove here is going to hold the valve rod in place. The valve rod, when it's machined, will have a little protrusion on it that will run in this groove right here. And so that keeps the valve guide or the valve rod from falling off of this. This operation is going to require partially a three-jaw chuck, and then I'll switch over to a four-jaw chuck. Now, eccentrics are not that difficult at all to turn. They're fairly straightforward. It's just a few setups along the way, and I'll show you what those are. Let's go to the lathe and get started. Okay, here we are at the lathe, and this is just a piece of mild steel. And the first thing I'm going to do is bring this just down to a smooth finish. I'm going to face it off and bring it down to a smooth finish. Not going to do any center drilling or anything like that to it. But just touch off and get a nice smooth running finish on the outside and do the end. Okay, I've got the facing all done. Now what I want to do is go in and just touch off the center. That's all I want to do is touch off the center. And then I'll show you how to back it out 3/32 of an inch. What I'm going to do is come in and I'm just going to put the marker and just spot the end of that right in the center. I'm not going to center drill it, but I am going to bring the center drill up and just touch off right in the center. Now I'm going to get this in, and then I'm going to bring this in, and I'm going to get the edge of that cutter. I'll bring that cutter off. What that is, that's a triangle cutter, and I'm going to just bring this side of the cutter and put it right on that center spot. So I'll come in, I'm going to go past it. I'm going to go this way towards the back of the lathe. I'm going to go past the dot, my center, and I'm going to bring it back to it. That'll take care of my backlash. When I get that edge of that located exactly right on that center pip, which it is, now I've got that lined up to it. Here's what I do. Set my lathe at zero, and then I back up the lathe 3/32 of an inch. And 3/32 of an inch is 93 thousandths, so I'll just bring it right back up. 93, so I brought that over 93 thousandths. Now I'm going to bring this in, and then I'm just going to turn this around. Now when you back it off, I don't know if you can see that or not, but what that is a line right there that's 3/32 off center. I can come over here to 3/32, go double check it, put my measure in the middle, and it is 3/32, right on the money, just exactly like it should be. So now I've got to, that's where the hole will be. The offset hole is offset 3/32 of an inch. Now let's get started. I'll show you how I have to set it up. But before I take it out, I need to get a mark on that, or put a little pip on that mark right there on that line. The way I'm going to do that is get the optimizer, and then I'm just going to push it down like that. By the way, these right here, that's an optimizer, and that's a 3-power with a little loop on it, and I use it a lot. So now I'm just going to come down in through here, and I'm just going to pick, just put a little pip mark right on that outside mark with my prick punch. So now I've got a layout mark right on the end of that. Now I just need to put in the four-jaw chuck and then line it up. Okay, I got the 4-jaw chuck on there. Now we're going to go ahead and, I'm going to go to the bench and I'm going to put just a little bit deeper mark in the little prick punch I had to go ahead and put a little bit deeper punch in there so I can line it up better. Okay, I've got the 4-jaw chuck on here now. So now I'm just going to put this in and we'll do the lining up with the 4-jaw chuck. Now a little hint. Since I put the punch mark is 3/32 off center, it saves a little time if you just go ahead and put that in line with one of the axes on the 4-jaw chuck. I'm just going to go ahead and put that in. It's off quite a bit, I can tell that just by looking. I don't have to do anything. And I'm just going to get it lined up by eyeball first. I've actually shown this in a couple of videos before. I don't know if I've shown it yet in this series or not, but this is a great little shop project. It's just two pieces of drill stem that's put together, 60 degree point on that end, 60 degree center drill on that end, and what it does, it goes, I put a dead center in the tailstock, bring it up, I put that right where that mark was. And then I just bring this up to that, put a little bit of spring tension, not much, it doesn't need much spring tension. And just by doing that, now I've got a visual as to which way I need to turn. So obviously I got to turn over this way, bring this one in. That one's got to go over. Okay, took a little twisting and turning to do that, but I've got it down to about 0.5 thousandths. Good enough, so we'll go ahead and take this off. And what I'm going to do is to start with, take this back out, put it back in my toolbox. And what I'm going to start doing is I'm going to bring this shoulder off right here. And probably need to slow my lathe down a little bit to do that because it's a pretty intermittent cut. So let me change belts real quick. That's a pretty big intermittent cut, so I'm going to use something that's really well supported. When you're doing eccentric cuts, always make sure you turn your chuck around because that'll break a tool post if that thing, a tool holder real quick if it hits that right when you first start up. Now the next thing to do is come in and start drilling the hole for my 1/4 inch, for the 1/4 inch crankshaft. All right, all drilled out, brought it up to size, brought it 13/64 or 15/64, and gonna go get the 1/4 inch reamer now. 1/4 inch reamer. A little tap magic this time. Tap magic and reamers do really good. And I'm gonna come in, and I have a little airbrush compressor. Works really well for it. So it's not very high pressure, not a lot of volume, works real well. I just have a little plastic coat hanger that I got the end of it off and hang it right here by the edge of my lathe. It really works good. I put a little tap magic up inside. And let's go to town. Let's drive it home here and see what we got. Little crankshaft material. Perfect. Perfect. Absolutely perfect. Well, now I've got a couple more operations. I'm through with the 4-jaw chuck. Now I can go back to the 3-jaw chuck. Alrighty, now I'm going to put that back in there, and we're getting ready to part that little rascal off and put a little notch in it, put a little groove in it. With as much work as I've got into that thing, I'm going to do it right here. So I'm going to, this first day of daylight savings time, and I've been working all day. Have been known to make a mistake. I've got too much work in it right now to put that slot in the wrong place. So we'll do the measure twice and cut once thing here. Now we're getting somewhere. Now I need to go over there. 7/8 more thousandths. And then we'll cut it off. There's that. All right. I'm going to call that done. I'm going to take it right over here to the belt sander and just touch up the back of it just a little bit, put just a little light polish on it. Then we'll come back and take a look at it on the crankshaft. Well, that's the eccentric that just got through turning. Got the groove in it. All the spacing is just right and so forth. Now I've got to drill a hole for a little set screw in there. Now there's a lot of different ways you can line and get this thing straight and get it all equal. As I've said before, I don't have a whole lot of tooling, and what I've had I've just collected down through the years. So I've had to come up with other things that seem to work pretty good. Now here's how I find the center of something that needs to have the set screw coming in to look like it's supposed to, in other words, be visually appealing, it needs to be in a straight line. Here's how I do that. I just take a nail, put over that, and then I let that thing find its center. Once it finds its center, then all I have to do, I'm gonna move it over a little bit, all I have to do now at this point is just draw up the vise, hold it down a little bit, and draw up the vise, and now that hole, when I drill it, when I get ready here in just a minute to center punch and get it started, it'll be in line and it'll be vertical looking with the crankshaft. I'll be right back after I drill that hole. Well, that's the eccentric that made out of mild steel. I've gone ahead and put a 440 grub screw in it. It just fits on the end of the crankshaft like that. Now, if you're watching this in the playlist, you're not quite up to speed because I had changed the crankshaft size. Actually, in number 13, I had to backtrack and rebuild this eccentric because the first one was not the right size for this engine. I had to redo it. But if you're following the playlist, it'll be in order. If you're just following along the project, this is actually backtracking a little bit. I still have to go back in and cut the journals out of the crankshafts here and let it go with it. But nice eccentric. It's going to work really well, and it'll be just fine on this engine. The next step, I'll probably come back and just get this crankshaft ready. I may or may not show that on the video because I've already showed it on one earlier than this. See you on the next video. Because this thing has to be off center, and it needs to be off center by, I forgot how much it's off center by. Be right back. Where did it go? All right, that is, it's only 3/16 wide. Dial indicator, and put it right over here on the carriage. Zero it, and I need to come in 78 thousandths. 78 thousandths. Now I need to come out 78 plus 32, 110, that's what 110 looks like. All right, somewhere under the lathe is the eccentric, which is also probably pretty hot. Well, there you have one eccentric. All you got to do now is just put the, well, it won't go. Oh, I got to ream it out. I drilled a hole in it.